Hello friends, in today's lecture we are going to take a brief idea about the wave impedance in TM and TE modes and briefly discuss the circular waveguides. Now, what is wave impedance? Now, wave impedance is defined as the ratio of the strength of electric field in one transverse direction to the strength of the magnetic field along other transverse direction. So if we see these, this is the direction of EX and this is the direction of magnetic field, then the wave impedance can be defined as the ratio of this EX over HY, this EX divided by this HY, or minus of EY over HX. So we can say this Z impedance, wave impedance, can be written as the ratio of these two factors under the root EX square plus EY square divided by under the root of HX square plus HY. Now we are going to see the value of these wave impedances for TM and for TE wave. Now let us consider first the case of TM wave. Now here, as we know, this wave impedance is nothing but this is the ratio of this EX upon HY. So as we have already calculated the value of EX and HY for TM wave, so we are going to replace those values of EX and HY, and by replacing these value we get this is equals to EX. You can how we have calculated these value, you can go to my previous lectures where I have derived these particular equations. Similarly, this HY is replaced by this factor. So this is going to represent the wave impedance. Now, because we are dealing with the TM wave, so HZ here will be 0 and gamma will be equals to J of beta if we assume attenuation factor is 0. As we know, gamma was the sum of alpha plus J beta. So if we assume that attenuation is 0, then we can say our propagation constant will be equals to J times of the phase constant. So this equation for TM case will be having only these two terms, EZ and HZ, because here for TM this HZ will be 0, so this part of the numerator will be 0, and also in denominator part here also this HZ will be 0 for TM, so this will be also be 0. So we are having this term divided by this term, and so we can say this is the equation, and from here we can get ZTM equals to the ratio of beta over omega. Now we know that beta is again can be represented by this equation. So from here we get Z of TM equals to this particular equation, and for air this part, the ratio of under the root mu over epsilon, this is for air we can say the value is this 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 divided by this term, then this will be equals to for air this will be equals to neta 377 ohm, or we can say intrinsic impedance of free space. Sometime it is also written as 120 pi free space impedance. So if we replace this by neta, then our formula becomes impedance, wave impedance for transverse magnetic wave equals to neta into this whole term. This is our final equation. Now we can say for wave to propagate, we are having lambda naught is always less than lambda c. So we can say the wave impedance for TEM wave is always less than neta. This is the final result in case of TEM. So we can say wave impedance for TEM wave is always less than the free space impedance. So it is always be less than 120 pi or 377 ohm in case of TEM. Now consider the case of TE mode. Here again Z is nothing but this is the ratio of E by EX upon HY. So in similar fashion, for if we say we are considering this equation for TE mode, in that case the condition for TE is that EZ is 0, and if EZ is 0, then this numerator part, this first portion will be 0 for TE, and in denominator also if we consider the case of TE, then this EZ will be 0 and this second part of the denominator will also be 0. So we will get the ratio of this and this for TE case. So again for TE wave EZ was 0, and again if we assume that our again attenuation is 0 and gamma is equals to j of times the beta, so for here TE mode also we get that Z of TE is omega mu over beta. Now here also we can replace in a similar fashion that we have done in our TM case. This vector we can replace this by neta, and by replacing this by neta, which is free space impedance or 377 ohm, then our wave impedance for TE case will be neta divided by under the root 1 minus lambda naught by lambda c square. Now here also as we know that lambda naught is always less than lambda c, so we can say that wave impedance in case of transverse electric mode will always be greater than that of neta. So this is the condition. Now take the case for the TEM wave. Here the cutoff frequency is 0 and the wave impedance for TEM wave is free space impedance itself. That is, for TEM wave the free space impedance is equals to the wave impedance of the wave. That is why we say wave impedance for TEM wave is equals to neta. Now for air as a dielectric, lambda g can be written by this, and the other factor that when your dielectric constant is ER, then our lambda g can be represented by this, and lambda g dielectric can be given by lambda g air divided by under the root of ER. And since this ER is always is greater than 1, and the wavelength for the dielectric is less than the wavelength for air, hence frequencies less than cutoff value can pass through the same guide. Also the power transmission in a rectangular waveguide can be given by this particular relation, where the transmitted power is a function of your free space impedance, EX component and EY component, and the power handling capacity of a rectangular waveguide, which is greater than the case of coaxial line, is given by this formula, where this ED is dielectric strength of the insulating material in waveguide f maximum, this is the maximum frequency, and this f, this is the operating frequency, and this fc is the cutoff frequency. Now let us briefly see about circular waveguides. Now a circular waveguide is basically a tubular circular conductor, as we can see in this particular figure, where the inner radius is assumed to be equals to a, and the length of this waveguide is assumed to be length here. The phi varies from 0 to 2 pi, this, and rho varies from 0 to a, this is 0, and at this it is having its maximum value, that is a, and the length is along the z axis. We have placed this along z axis, so that we can say the direction of propagation is towards z direction. Now Helmholtz wave equation for TE and TM wave traveling in z direction in a circular waveguide are given by this: delta square Hz equals to 0, and also delta square Ez equals to 0 for this particular circular waveguides. Now let us have a look on various advantages and disadvantages of a circular waveguide over a rectangular waveguide. Now when we discuss the advantages, the advantages can be described as follows. First, these are easy to manufacture and join as compared to the rectangular waveguide. Second, TE01 has lowest attenuation in a circular, so suitable for the long distance transmission as compared to the rectangular waveguides. Now there are many disadvantages of circular waveguides also, as we compare them with a rectangular waveguide. First disadvantage is they are going to occupy more space. Second disadvantage, plane of polarization rotates when wave travels through the waveguide due to the roughness or discontinuities. Also, polarization changes affect the received signal, resulting in reflection of the transmitted signal. And there are infinite number of modes, so it is very difficult to separate them, so interference to dominant mode is always possible. And the some of the application of circular waveguide are, they are being used at a rotating joints in a radar system. Also TE01 is used for long distance transmission, that is above 10 gigahertz, because as we have said, we are getting lowest attenuation in this particular mode, so this is used for long distance transmission. And also short and medium distance broadcast band communication are also possible with the help of this circular waveguides. So friends, this was a brief description about wave impedance in case of TM and TE mode, and also a very brief description about the circular waveguides, their advantages, disadvantages, and the application part. So this is all for today's lecture. Thanks. Have a very nice day.